Hi guys! So, 2 weeks ago, as you know, my lift broke down in my building. Not my lift, the communal lift. And it wasn't until yesterday that it's fixed. Yesterday afternoon, although no one told me it was fixed. So I had to go out and push the button and hope that it didn't crash and burn if I got in, which again is a problem that Guinness can't even be bothered to tell people who need the lift when it's fixed. Just seems like common courtesy to me. So, fingers crossed, as I told you on Wednesday, it will probably break again. It's just a matter of time. Meanwhile, I've done a bit of research, as I promised you I would do, and I found something fascinating. I'll put the link below. It's a link to an article that's posted on the LSE website. The headline is 1.8 million people are struggling to find accessible housing in the UK. Now, while this is interesting, it's because the LSE and the Papworth Trust jointly formed a research paper that says, these people, nearly 2 million people, have an unmet housing need. 580,000 of them are working in a working age and have the income to put a down payment on a house, which is different than what we are often told. We are often assuming that disabled people live on benefits. Hi, I don't live on benefits, just so you know. And I never have. And that they can't afford housing. 58% of this 58% of this 1.8 million have savings to pay for mortgages and put a down payment on the house. The problem is, there aren't houses out there. 39% of those 1.8 million have incomes that are higher than the average mean point. So these people have money and they can't find houses to buy, which is a market problem. Now, for years, no one built houses to accommodate people with disabilities, which is a huge problem. After an accident, you come home in your chair and you can't even get through the front door. And then there's not bedrooms downstairs, all sorts of problems. Houses were built for only able-bodied people. 19% of the British population, according to this paper, states that they would be willing to move immediately if they can find accessible housing. That's nearly 1 in 5 people who are ripe for the property market. This is where Guinness comes in. As I have said before, when Guinness built this building, they were required to build first floor properties to be made accessible. They were not, however, required to sell those properties to disabled people. And in fact, I discovered during my reading yesterday that once those flats were sold to able-bodied people, they were not required to keep the adaptations. Sorry, literature coming at me. They were not required to keep the adaptations in their homes. So basically, you have a chain of creating accessible housing, selling accessible housing to people that don't need accessible housing, and then giving them the freedom to get rid of all accessibility features. Now, you guys know that I am pretty fiscally conservative, a lot more fiscally conservative than a lot of people my age. But even from a capitalist argument, this makes no sense. You are literally taking boxes by creating accessible housing across London and then getting rid of it, allowing these families who bought their homes and have a right to do whatever they want with their homes, and I completely agree they have that right. But you're creating accessible housing and then turning around and destroying it. Here's the thing about money. Green is green. Doesn't matter if it's my money, a person of color's money, a woman's money, a man's money. Doesn't matter. A pound is a pound is a pound. And really, London has a massive housing market need that then is not given the opportunity to create the fill for that need because it's being sold to people that don't need those flats. This isn't about welfare, again. We need to stop the belief that all disabled people must be on benefits and must need a handout. Some of us are privileged enough to be financially independent, but when we are not able to buy the appropriate accessible housing we need because it is being sold to able-bodied people. Sorry, what's the point of building it in the first place? You're just gonna waste money for yourselves and for the buyers who will change it back to how they want it. This is going on across London and across the UK, and we need politicians that will step up to the plate and call out organizations like Guinness Homes, like Lendlease, and going, are you really out to help the community and to create sustainable living, to create future-proof living, as my flat was, but then put in a shitty lift? That's not okay. I encourage you to talk to your local council people, see if this is going on in your area. If there is a high-rise building being built, if there is a new building being built, chances are they have to check these boxes. But But a box taking exercise isn't going to help anyone. We need real change at the government level. Okay. It's Friday. It's a beautiful day. My lift is working for now. I'm gonna go outside and enjoy the weather. So, as always, remember, you are loved, you are precious, and you contain multitudes. Bye!